kind of annoying.
Yeah, it's not been going as well as I meant, I guess. Like, just been a constant struggle.
Yeah, if somebody really wanted to go, they should just come and see Paris.
It's kind of cool to give some people an idea of one, you know? And
that's
hopefully
helpful,
it builds
too.
The excitement, so.
Yeah, I suppose I would do that if I was dating. But yeah.
Sorry.
I thought you were saying we're good to go.
Okay, now we're good.
Hey guys, welcome back to Tiny Fest Midwest. You got your host Jazz and the man behind the cam, Brandon.
What's up, guys?
So we're here with Andrew. We're going to look at his awesome bus build. Now keep in mind, he is still finishing up things as we all are on our tiny homes.
Yep.
But it's pretty awesome inside, so let's go check it out.
If you guys see it, there's a smokestack up top, and yes, he does have a roof raise and a rooftop deck. So.
Boom. Oh, that's like
it's
thing?
Yeah.
Oh my
I
god.
I can close it if you want.
That's cool.
Okay. Yeah, so it closes just as easy as like any screen door.
Okay.
And it's actually tempered glass, you know, so it won't break if you kind of hit something through it.
I mean, guys.
On a road, for sure.
You have to grab the door, it's going to close.
Oh, sorry, yeah.
It no, he just doesn't know that. I like barely hit this.
Yep. So, yeah, we had added insulation on there. We're from Minnesota, so we kind of had to add insulation on the floor and ceiling. So that's why we kind of, main reason behind the roof raise pretty much.
Okay.
Like emergency source of heat when it gets down to like negative temperatures, and that comes in handy. It still has the ash in it from the last couple of years we've used it.
Okay.
Double wall pipe with the fever box, so the insulation never touches the actual pipe with the chimney. Fireproof the whole thing. It's made out of a metal frame underneath, then a fireproof concrete board, and then mortar underneath it, or on top of it. And then the rocks are all from Lake Superior, from Minnesota. So we have to bring some of Minnesota with us.
That's really cool.
Yeah. So then there's the backup camera. It's attached to the back. Plays DVDs. Bluetooth connects to your phone. Does all that. Four speakers for on the road driving. Five-speed manual transmission. Thing runs great. We can top out about 70 miles per hour. Any more than that, you probably shouldn't be driving.
Yeah.
And so this is our guest bed. It's not completed yet, but right now it's all one cushion. Each thing slides out. You know, you want to make an L-shaped couch, or if both end people want to recline, they can. It also folds up and will hold all of our electrical equipment, as in like the inverter, the solar panel, your circuit panel, just the batteries, anything you can fit under there, pretty much. And the fridge will pretty much be about right in here. Got a wall mount TV. I built custom PCs, so I kind of had to bring all this with me. Kind of a Live Edge, Ponderosa Pine, from the Black Hills. This oil and glaze coat on it. On here, in the living room and the bedroom. And they are all also good, so you're not getting blinded at night by the light.
Yeah,
so yeah, overhead storage.
Oh. Look at how much space they have above their head, too, in a school
sure.
bus.
Yeah. This
then,
beats Bougie's head space.
Yeah. And then a nice big pantry for all your food right there.
Yeah.
There will be trim door on here when you get to it.
Awesome.
And it's pretty much water heater under there, and then the water manifold, which is going to be like dishes and comfort, looking out, you know, whatever scenery, mountains, you know, you name it, do your dishes, and finally make fun job of dishes.
Nice.
And, so then back here we have the shelves. Yeah, this is a do-it-yourself model. There's the exhaust toilet paper area, and this is the compost material, sawdust, peat moss, and a little bit of cinnamon. So with this fan connected to the bucket, and we gotta put the seat on there, jigsaw it out, make it workable.
Mm-hmm.
Eventually we'll, so it's not a lack in there. As well as like a shower being here. Still got concrete tile it all out. Concrete board, waterproof it, tile it. And then there's a frosted window here actually for some privacy.
Oh, nice.
And opens up to let, you know, moisture out if you're taking a shower. It's got to make the drain hole, the base, all that still. But yeah, this is pretty good shower. You know, I can fit into here. It's pretty good.
Yeah.
So yeah, hopefully it'll be all right.
Nice.
And then you move the door, it all shuts. It's completely lockable. As well as, you know, this one again, some outlets or on
nice.
It for your charging your phone at night. If you
that's
your,
always important.
Yeah, if you want your laptop on it, you know, we might eventually, like, make a fold-down table here for, like, a little office back here as well. Or aromatic cedar board on the shelf.
Great.
And it's been...
Awesome.